Hi everyone, so today we'll discuss construction details and working of rotary engine, which is investigated by or discovered by this Wankel, and hence it can be known as Wankel engine. So we'll just first go through the introduction. As you can see here in the sketch, this form of engine can be called as Wankel engine or rotary engine. Obviously the name itself implies that why it can be called as rotary engine, because we will be having a piston that can be called as rotor, which is rotating other than reciprocating in the case of conventional engines. So this is a type of internal combustion engine that uses rotary design, and the name it can be called as rotary engine. It uses four stroke cycle, which is used in conventional engines. And it is developed in 1951 by Felix Wankel, and hence it can be called as Wankel engine. And many advancements later on has been carried out in this engine. So you have to just observe this engine. So the design of this engine, which is completely different if we compare it with the reciprocating engine, we'll be having this rotor. So this is the rotor, which is rotating and which is placed on the output shaft. Then we'll be having this housing. So this is the housing, this is the rotor. Then there are few holes which will be used to fasten the bolts, and few holes are provided for lubrication purpose. Then we'll be having inlet and outlet valves that we later see in next part. So rotor on eccentric shaft, so it is mounted on the eccentric shaft, output shaft, and to minimize volume while maximum compression ratio. So this is the most disadvantage employed with this rotary engine as compared to, if we compare compression ratios of conventional engines and compression ratios of this engines, then compression ratios are very less in case of rotary engines. And this rotor is used, Riolox rotor, which is triangular in shape with equal width. See, the strokes are same as compared to previous engine. We'll be having intake stroke, we'll be having compression, combustion and exhaust stroke. So the important parts, as we have already discussed, first is rotor. Rotor design is again very important. Then we'll be having housing. In this housing, coolant passages will be provided, intake and exhaust ports will be provided, and spark plug will be provided. And output shaft, which design is like eccentric lobes on which this rotor is mounted. Means when the rotor will rotate, it will transfer its motion to the output shaft and hence to the engine. So this is the rotor. Simple. Some parts, see, this part is used to mount on the lobes, output shaft lobes, and where at the same time it is attached with the external threads of the output shaft, so that when this rotor will rotate, this output shaft will also rotate. And we'll be having one apex seal at the end, as it is continuously sliding inside the cylinder or inside the housing. See, the rotor has, as we have already discussed, it has internal gear teeth cut into the center of the one side. This teeth met with the gear, which is fixed on the housing. So housing, it is roughly oval in shape, as we have already seen. We can better understand with the help of this sketch. So this is the housing provided with the, we can see here, provided with the coolant passageways. Then these holes are used to fasten the second half part to it with the help of bolts. And then we'll be having this intake port, and this is the exhaust port. Through this intake port, fuel will be inducted in this chamber, and exhaust gases will be escaped out this exhaust port. And then we'll be having the spark plugs. We'll be having one in number, we'll be having two in number. This varies according to the design. So this is the output shaft, as you can say. So this is mounted as this, the motion of this rotary shaft is eccentric. So likewise, this output shaft is also designed so that the output motion will not be eccentric, the output motion will be circular. So operation, now we'll see the simple operation of this rotary engine. As we said, it uses four stroke combustion cycle. The heart of rotary engine is obviously the rotor, which can be called as piston in previous cases. So we'll just better understand with the help of these strokes. So the first stroke, we know that it is always an intake stroke. See, when this rotor will start moving towards right side or toward the clockwise, then what will happen? This rotor will change the position. Maybe this rotor may acquire this type of position. So what will happen here, you have to observe. See, this volume is very low. As soon as this will rotate, this volume will increase, and as a result of it, the suction will be created here. And due to that suction, see, this fuel will be sucked inside this cylinder. So you have to observe the design. See, it is very important. See, in first case, here you have to observe. See, the volume at this point is large. Volume at this point is also large, but compare this. So the rotor is designed in such a way that at some point of contact, it compresses the fuel and the volume need to be reduced. So accordingly, this rotor is designed, and accordingly this low profile where this rotor is mounted is designed so that a proper compression will be taken place. But it is still low as compared to the previous engines. So intake fuel will be taken inside the cylinder or inside the cylinder or housing. Then as soon as this rotor will rotate, what will happen? This fuel will be compressed. So we'll get this. Now the volume is reduced and that fuel is compressed. So at the end of compression stroke, sparking will be taken place, as you can see here. And due to the energy, heat energy, which will impact, heat energy produced, which will impact this rotor, and this rotor will tend to move towards in the same direction, so clockwise direction. So accordingly the combustion will be taken place and this rotor will move. See, you'll find here few threads will be provided on this output shaft, but the number of threads are very less. So the one rotation will tend to rotate the output shaft around thrice, as you can see here. This is very less number of teeth, and here we will find higher number of teeth. So one rotation will tend to rotate this output shaft thrice. So this is a power stroke, and then exhaust stroke. As soon as this will rotate, the exhaust gases will be escaped out of the cylinder. So likewise, these four strokes will be carried out in case of this rotary engine. And now we'll see the advantages. This is simple working of this rotary engine. There are few advantages, there are few disadvantages as far as this rotary engine is considered. So first is much simpler comparing to its piston counterpart, making it more reliable. So if we look for the rotational moment in case of previous engine, then we'll find that the reciprocating motion need to be transferred in rotary motion of crankshaft in previous engines, where the power loss will be there. But here we are transferring rotary moment into rotary moment. So this is a more reliable case. I just repeat, to transfer the motion from reciprocating to rotary, the power loss will be there or the energy will be wasted. However, to transfer rotary motion into rotary motion, there will be a very less power loss, and that engine can be called as more reliable engine. Power to weight ratio is also superior, and smooth power flow and high RPM. Obviously, rotary motion is transferred in the rotary motion, so the power flow is smooth. And challenges, this is challenges, or you can say this is the disadvantages as far as this engine is concerned. It consumes more fuel because thermodynamic efficiency of this engine is reduced by long combustion chamber shape and low compression ratios. As we talked about, there are very low compression ratios, and due to that might be fuel will be more fuel need to be supplied, and this fuel efficiency of this engine is less as compared to previous engines. And in manufacturing cost, see, these engines are not widely used, so the manufacturing cost obviously increases because production number is less. These are two challenges instead of this development of these rotary engines. And applications, nowadays there is a car called as Mazda RX 800. In that, basically this rotary engine is used. However, few other applications also this engine can be used, like in Volkswagen or Mercedes-Benz cars. In seatbelt retentioner systems, this concept is used, rotary engine concept is used. However, in some compressor also to compress the air, and in supercharger to boost the air also, this rotary concept is used. So this was all about the rotary engines or Wankel engines.